In the world of 3D modeling and visualization, there are many ways to brighten our scenes and bring the atmosphere to life. HDR images are one of the most frequently used methods for this purpose. However, we may not always have access to these images. This is where Blender's Dynamic Sky plugin comes into play. Dynamic Sky allows users to create fully customizable and realistic skies and lighting effects without the needs for HDR images. This plugin allows us to control many details, from the color of the sky to cloud density to the position of the sun. This is especially useful when we want to light our scene at a specific time, in a specific weather condition, or in a specific season. With Dynamic Sky, you can achieve all these weather conditions. First, let's open Blender. Under Edit, click on Preferences. When this window opens, we need to select Add-ons from the options on the left side. Then, type Dynamic Sky in the search box. It will find it even if you just type Sky. If you haven't installed this add-on before, you can install it by clicking on the box on the left. There is no restart in Blender. It will install it directly when you check this box. Now, let's slowly start using Dynamic Sky. The first thing we are going to do is to create the environment, that is to create the sky. For this, I press the letter N on the keyboard or I click on the little arrow here. When I press the letter N, this menu will open. Here, we are going to go to the Create tab, and you will see Dynamic Sky here. If you see that, then the plugin has been successfully installed. When I open this with the arrow, you will see the Create button. I click on the Create button once. I clicked it. It is going to give me a message here. Go to World and select More Dynamic One. Immediately, I click on the World tab here to go to World Properties. And then I click on the arrow next to World. And I see that there is an option here called Dynamic One, through the Create button that we just clicked on. I'm clicking on that, and then you will see this on the right hand side. If after a few seconds you don't see the options here, click on another tab, then you click on the Create tab again to make this appear in this area. Now let's see if the sky has successfully arrived. In order to see if the sky is here, we need to go into shading mode. So, we need to click on this icon. Then, when we look at the sky, you will see that the sky is here. You can do a lot of customization through the menu here, from the color of the sky to the cloud density. For example, you can increase or decrease the cloud path by looking at the cloud options. A little bit further down, you can change the brightness of the sun. We can even change the angle of the sun by going a little bit further down to the sphere. Now let's add the monkey to the scene. We can see the effect on the monkey more easily. I select Mesh with Shift A and select Monkey. Let's enlarge this by pressing the letter S. We can also delete the cube. Look how smooth this sky we added made a smooth shading. We can get a smoother look by adding subdivision surface from the Modifier tab. Now we can look at the settings. There is even a light here. We can make this light disappear right now. We are already using the skylight. Let's change the color of the sky, for example. See, when I change the color of the sky effect is automatically, of course, naturally, reflected on the object at the same time. Horizon color is the color of the horizon line. We can change that too if we want. This is actually the point where the sky meets the earth. We can understand this much more easily by creating a plane. Imagine creating a plane like this. Look, this is how we can change the colors of the moments when the sky ends and approaches the horizon line. Let's do some editing on the cloud. If we do one, it is a more natural result. If you want to change the cloud density, you can increase or decrease the cloud density option. It allows you to edit the cloud density. The soft hard part is the brightness of the sun. When I move it closer to zero, the sun hits more sharply. I move it to the right to increase the softness. In the circle area below, we can determine the angle. Look, I have moved it to the bottom left, where the sun is hitting from the bottom left. When I move it to the top right, the angle of the sun changes. It goes to the top right. You can change the brightness value above. Now, there is a point I want to draw your attention here. We just talked about horizon color, the color of the horizon line. The horizon line starts from the point where the sky ends. It starts from about here. It continues all the way here and if there was no ground, it would continue even further down. This is actually a long area. You might want to change this. I'll show you where you can change it. Above, we open the shader editor. We change the object mode to world. The node system we just created with our Dynamic Sky plugin is automatically created in this way. So, we can call it a very comprehensive node system. The place we should care about here is color ramp. If you notice, color ramp provides these two color transitions. It provides the mix. Therefore, by changing the gradient area here, we can have a direct effect on the horizon. Right now, this is the way it is. It is set like this by default, so after half of it, it switches to the horizon logic. Look, it is about here. Now let's keep this image in mind. I come back to the shader editor and we can grab and drag this triangle. It is dragging it to the left so that it is close to white. Now I go to the 3D viewport again and the horizon line, which was just here, has now come here with the editing we have done. So we are going to make the sky more prominent and we are going to reduce the color of the horizon line. Now that we have learned about these features, I will show you how to do the night view. And again, we are going to do the night view by changing the colors. The colors that best reflect the night are the colors in the dark blue scale. Let's make the saturation value 1. Let's make the value 0.1. And when we look at the sky, we will see dark blue colors. In the same way, we need to change the horizon color and cloud color according to the color we just gave. When I click on horizon color, there is an eyedropper icon here. When we click on this icon and click on the color we just selected, it will automatically select that color. We will do the same thing for cloud. As you can see, the sky is completely dark blue. But when we look at the scene, it is still bright. In order to darken this bright environment, that is, to turn it into night mode, we need to change the sun value. We can make it 0.4, for example. When we make it 0.4, as you can see, there is a darkness that the eye can see, even if it is not completely dark environment. Maybe we can also call it the image for the moon in the sky above. Yes, that's all for this video. In this video, I showed how we can make the sky without any visuals, without HDR images. I can say that the Dynamic Sky plugin in Blender is really very practical and useful in this respect. It doesn't leave you in need of an image. It provides a very nice environment by directly changing the settings in itself. I hope it was useful. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.